What's up, guys? It's Bruno from the BTNHD, and yes, today is all about downloading Azure VM and then optimizing that basically virtual hard disk. Yeah, right? All right, let's get started. All right, so to get started, we need to open up your favorite browser. Mine is Chrome. So I'm going to go inside the URL text box and type in portal.azure.com, hit enter. It's going to take me here. I'm going to put my email address, hit next. It's going to want my password. I'm going to enter my password and then sign in, and you should have this as your Azure portal. Now on your left hand side, we need to locate virtual machines, and you're going to see all your virtual machines that you have within your Azure portal. Now the one that I am going to export so I can optimize and then use it within my Hyper-V environment locally within my lab, I'm going to pick the VPN. And then from here, we need to get inside settings. And within settings, we are going to pick disk. Now within disk, I am going to select my VPN disk, and it's gonna take me here, all right? And then we need to go inside the following disk export. How easy is that? Now the URL by default is 3600 seconds, so make sure you change it so the URL will not expire on you, because again, you're downloading a huge container. Now this VPN is around 127 gigs. That's how big the virtual hard disk is. And so I need to increase that URL. And this, I'm gonna give it 36,000 seconds. And then once you give it, click on generate the URL. And on the upper right corner, you're going to see it's generating the URL. Once it's completed, it's gonna take you to this. This is the URL that you are able to copy and paste it to your favorite browser. It's going to start downloading the VHD file locally to your machine. Now, take in consideration that this VHD is going to be huge. Like I said before, mine is 127 gigs. So make sure that your local machine that you're downloading this virtual hard disk has enough space. So I'm going to click on download this VHD file. And because I'm using Chrome, on the lower left hand side, you're going to see that it is downloading. It says 7 hours. And for me, I had a couple of problems because the download failed. Don't freak out. Just click on the little arrow and just say resume. Eventually, it's going to download and complete. You're able to click on that little arrow and say show in folder. And there goes our 127 plus VHD file. Now, we are going to go to our start menu, and we're going to type in Windows PowerShell. You can do it within a Windows PowerShell commandlet, but I like to use the Windows PowerShell ISC, and I'm going to right click on that and run it as an administrator. Hit yes on the user account control, and the first command that we need to run is the following. Now, when I did my research within the Microsoft website, it told me to run this. I ran it, but I got, you know, a couple of issues right here, and the way that I fixed it was running the same command, right, which is enable Windows optional features with a parameter of dash online with another parameter of dash feature name Microsoft Hyper-V Management PowerShell, right, with all dashes in between all those words. But the way that I got it to work is I had to add an additional parameter of dash all. Ran it again, it worked with no problem, and it wanted me to restart my machine. So I hit yes, it started restarting, and then boom, logged back into my machine. Open up Windows PowerShell ISC as an administrator. I went inside my downloads folder because I wanted to make sure the correct name of that virtual hard disk that I downloaded. Went back inside my PowerShell and I ran the following commandlet, because 127 gigs is huge. You don't really need that. So we need to optimize it to the point that we are able to use it within our Hyper-V local environment. So I ran the following, which was optimize-vhd with a parameter of dash path and the location of where that VHD file that I downloaded, which was inside the downloads, and another parameter of dash mode and what type of mode. Now I did it full. And I ran it. It started compacting the virtual disk. And once it's completed, you're done. Now, my results with optimizing the VHD, which was 127 gigs, I got it up to, with this particular mode full and this commandlet optimize VHD, I think I got it up to maybe 100 gigs. which is a big difference between 127 gigs to 100. So that's really big. So hopefully you guys enjoy this video. If you are optimizing your VHD files, what command line are you using? Also leave comments far below if you are downloading or uploading VHD files to your Azure portal. Don't forget about hitting that like button. Also hit that subscribe button, punch it, squeeze it, smash it. Do whatever you need to do to hit that subscribe button. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.